Hi, I'm Jade from Jobber. Let's talk about your workflow in the Jobber app. Let's take a look at the entire workflow, adding a client into the app, creating a request, into a quote, to a job, to an invoice, and getting paid. Let's say you need to go look at the property in order to give a quote to the customer. To do this, you'll schedule a request and get this time into your schedule. From the Schedule tab in the app, tap on a time where you want to book the assessment, and then choose New Request. Since this is a new client, we'll need to add them in. Tap to add a client, and then select Create New Client. Let's enter the new client's name and contact details, as well as their property information. Back onto the new request. Let's add a title, and if applicable, fill out the questions that you have set up on your request form. The time we tapped earlier is already selected for us in the assessment details section. We could change it if we needed. During the assessment, tap Convert to Quote to start building a quote. That's the next part of your workflow. You'll see a section for the request details and client info. These are here in case you need to reference them for this quote. Add a title and enter your line items. These are the products or services that you're offering on this quote. You can choose from your existing list of products and services or add a brand new line item. If you require your client to pay a deposit, add a required deposit either as a percentage or a dollar amount. Lastly, tap to add a message to your client. This might be additional details about the work, a disclaimer, or thanking them for their business. Once the quote is done, tap Save Quote. If you're there with the client, select Approve and Schedule so they can sign to approve the quote. You are now ready to schedule the job. The line items from the quote will carry over to the job automatically, but they can be edited or additional line items can be added. Next is setting up the schedule for this job. Tap the dates on the calendar to select a date for this job. If this job will take multiple days to complete, multiple dates can be selected, or repeating schedule can be set up to schedule recurring visits, for example, weekly. Then select a time and a team member to do this work. Once you're done, tap Save. Now if you've created a job, on your schedule, you'll see visits that were created as part of this job. When it's time to do the work, you can start a timer on the visit to log your time, and then when you're done, select Complete Visit. Depending on the job setup, you may be prompted to invoice now or later. Let's go ahead and create the invoice. All your line items transfer and can be edited if necessary. If you'd like to give your client a discount, tap the discount field and then enter the discount as a percentage or a dollar amount. Select Review and Send to preview how this invoice will look when your client views it in the Client Hub before you email or text it to them. Or if your client is with you and ready to pay, select Collect Payment to enter their payment details and send a receipt. That's the ideal app workflow in Jobber. We know that every business is different, so the workflow can be started at any stage. If your business doesn't need to make quotes, start by scheduling a job, or even create an invoice from scratch if you've had an emergency job that never got scheduled.
Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, be sure to check out the Help Center as well as our other videos.